So we ask God's mercy and compassion for our lives. You will send to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Together, let's say Gloria. Glory to God
in the
highest,
and
on earth peace to people of good will.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you, the Lord, are the only one. You are
the
Lord,
now the Lord.
We
are
Lord,
now the Most High Jesus Christ. Be the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. As we hold in this prayer, today is the funeral of two of our parishioners, Pat Farrell and Frank Gutsch. Funerals today at 2 o'clock, both. So we hold them in our prayer and their families as well. O God, who gladden us year by year with the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, graciously grant that by celebrating these present festivities, we may merit through them to reach eternal joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
Once, when Peter and John were up at the temple for the prayers of the ninth hour, it happened that there was a man who carried glass. He was a cripple from birth, and they used to put him down
every day near the temple entrance called so that he could beg from the people going in. When this man saw Peter and John on their way into the temple,
he begged from them. Both Peter and John looked straight down at him and said,
"Look at us."
He turned Peter to them expectantly, hoping to get
something from them, but Peter said,
proud of holy name.
Let the hearts that sing the Lord rejoice.
judgment with all his earth. Let all who seek the Lord rejoice. He remembers his covenant forever, his promises for a thousand generations, the covenant he made with Abraham, the oath he swore to Isaac. Let all who seek
the Lord rejoice.
You must be the only person staying in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have been happening there last few days. What things? He asked. All about Jesus of Nazareth, they answered, who proved he was a great prophet by the things he said and did in the sight of God and of the whole people. And how our chief priests and our leaders our own hope had been that he would be the one to set Israel free. And this is not all. 2 more days have gone by since it all happened, and some women from our group have astounded us, and they went to the tomb in the early morning, and when they did not find the body, they came back to tell us that they had seen a vision of angels who declared he was alive. Some of our friends went to the tomb and found everything exactly as the woman had reported, but of him they saw nothing. Then he said to them, "You foolish men, slow to believe the full message of the prophets. Was it not ordained that Christ should suffer and so enter into his glory?" Then, starting with Moses and going to all the prophets, he explained to them the passages throughout the scripture, what made God himself. When they drew near to the village to which they were going, he made as if to go on, but they pressed him to stay with them. "It is nearly evening," they said, "and the day is almost over." So he made him to stay with them. Now, while he was with them at table, he took the bread, set the blessing, then he broke it and handed it to them. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?" They set out that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, "Yes, it is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then they told their story of what had happened on the road and how they recognized him at the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
with the Lord Jesus Christ.
In this Easter Wednesday, we have gathered here for Mass. For the readings today speaks to us of Jesus' presence after his resurrection, that Jesus was seen to be with his disciples, but they failed to understand. Especially two of the disciples went to their homes, and Jesus himself was traveling along with them, but they failed to understand the stranger was Jesus. Even though this stranger tried to explain the passages of prophecies, but they failed to understand. Maybe they were thinking of Jesus as a great prophet, but they could not understand the death on the cross, because it was a shameful death, and they failed to recognize Jesus' own prediction of resurrection, which Jesus himself did when he was still with them. All they wanted was, all they understood was a shameful death on a cross, and so they were blinded with the things there. But they realized, especially these two disciples realized, at the breaking of the bread, because that's what Jesus used to do with them. Every time they gathered for meal, he took the bread, blessed it, broke it, gave to them. My brothers and sisters, this is what happens every time we come for the Eucharist. At the breaking of the bread and at the breaking of the word, we realize who Jesus is. And so in this time of pandemic, we cannot gather in church as community, but we can gather as family members in at the homes, where we also can break the bread and break the word. Parents or elders at homes has to gather together in a family setting to break the word and then break the bread, and we realize Jesus' presence amongst us. And the reading today speaks us that he is always with us. Whether we know or not, he is with us in difficult times as well as joyful moments. So let us hold on to him, that he will never church, that the leaders may guide their flock in this difficult time with encouragement. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear me.
We pray for the school, especially of our parish, as they have begun the school term today. Lord, help children and teachers to be safe in the environment. Lord, hear us. We also pray for the parish as the renovation started. Behold, the builders and everyone working in this site, that they may be protected with your loving care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We make all these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, we begin subject by your word and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord sacrifice your
hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and to your holy church. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice which has redeemed the human race, and be pleased to accomplish in us the salvation mind and body, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
This is what I say to us.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always to acclaim your Lord, but on this day evermore to Lord you. Yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, fount of all holiness. May only, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that thy may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, mystery of faith.
We proclaim the death, O Lord, and profess the resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us both to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Peter our Archbishop, all the clergy and the entire people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Saint's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace nowadays, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. disciples recognized the Lord Jesus in the breaking of the bread. Alleluia. Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that the reverent reception of the sacrament of your Son may cleanse us from our old ways and transform us into a new creation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you everyone for joining this Eucharist. Good news for you, we have started our renovation of the church, and so that's why we moved to this big hall here. So thank you, go gentle.